Tonight's breaking news on clashes between top officials over implementing the president's border policy. Executive order gives a top-down view of the problem. Right now, though, how what appears to be a policy train wreck, as well as a man-made human tragedy, is unfolding through the eyes of the people on the ground on the border. CNN's Martin Savidge reports.
It's the start of a deadly season. Summer in Arizona's high desert. It's 107 degrees, down from 110. The land is parched and so rugged it can shatter bones. There are many dangers here. Last week, a U.S. Border Patrol agent was shot multiple times. He survived. The gunman, they say, likely a drug trafficker or human smuggler that got away. Agent Dan Hernandez, along with other members of U.S. Customs and Border Protection, watch over a 262-mile stretch of border.
On a given day, we patrol an area the size of New Jersey.
New Jersey?
Yeah, I mean, it's a massive, massive...
Tucson is the second busiest sector in the country for drugs and illegal border crossings. Most agents here patrol alone, constantly spied on by human traffickers just over the way.
So as we're talking right now, there's two scouts up on that ridgetop.
The job's never been easy, but the president's immigration flip-flop hasn't helped.
Have you implemented the president's executive order?
Yes. U.S. Customs and Border Protection took steps immediately to implement the president's executive order.
According to Chief Karish, separated family members still in Border Patrol custody are being reunited. He can't speak for those in the hands of other agencies.
A family would not be prosecuted unless one of them had a criminal record.
Correct.
But they would go through a deportation process.
Correct.
An individual coming across will be prosecuted.
Correct.
For breaking the law.
Yes.
But what about the president's argument? The heartbreaking policy was a deterrent to prevent others from crossing illegally.
With the implementation of zero tolerance, have you seen a decline in those numbers then?
Our numbers have remained steady, but we also haven't been doing this long enough.
Little to no impact to border crossings, but the damage to the Border Patrol's public image may be immense. From the pictures of horrified children to their recorded cries in detention.
When you saw those pictures, when you heard that audio, what were you thinking?
The picture of the children crying.
Correct.
I mean, it's something that we've seen in the past. In 32 years, I've seen a lot of those situations up and down the border. So, I mean, it is something. It is something that goes at your heart.
Rank and file agents tell me they worry the public will continue to blame them for a president's failed policy.
There were people who believed that your agents were ripping children out of the hands of their parents.
Yeah.
Is that true? Did that happen?
False narrative. I mean, at the end of the day, it's a process that we have.
Meanwhile, Agent Hernandez continues to patrol in the heat and the hills of southern Arizona. He can now keep undocumented families he finds together. But in this deadly landscape, he's more concerned with just keeping them alive.
And Martin joins us now. What's your understanding of what happens to families after they've been processed for deportation?
Well, you know, this is an ever-evolving process. Let me tell you, first of all, the CBP is saying now they expect all the families that were in their custody to all be reunited by the end of the day today. So here's what happens. Those that are detained, and you can see the Customs and Border Patrol people right behind us here, what they do is they make the initial apprehension. They detain whoever comes across illegally. Take them back to the station, try to determine who they are. In other words, are they who they say they are? And also, are they really the parents of the minors that they may be with? That can take some time. But once they do that, and if they establish this is a legitimate family, the next step in the process is to notify ICE. That's Immigration and Customs Enforcement. And for that process, they come, collect them, and take them over to their world. And that's where the real deportation process goes. Could be two directions. One is the family can ask and request asylum. They begin that process. More than likely, though, it's going to be the deportation process, and eventually they're sent back to the country from where they began. That's how it was explained to me.
And you said that they're likely by the end of the day, those who have been separated, to be reunited. Where will they go once they've been reunited?
Okay, well, that is the part we still don't know. There are a lot of holes. When I asked where will they go and what time frame, they couldn't say. We only learned they're going to be reunited just a short while ago. When I asked earlier today, they had no idea. Every hour, it changes.